Okay. We have here veal shanks. Veal shanks come from just above the foot of the veal, the calf. You're looking at some beautifully cut, bone-in veal shanks, also known as ossobuco because they're the most popular cuts of meat to use in the ossobuco, a traditional Italian dish made with braised shank. You'll see it sometimes with lamb shank, but traditionally veal shank, braised shank. Cooked in a lot in red wine with maybe a little bit of mushrooms in the broth, in the cooking broth, and then served very classically with a saffron risotto, especially if you're from Milan. Now, what you're looking for is a nice thick, thick cut of the ossobuco. Okay, you're looking for a nice bone, a nice color to it too. And that little white bit of bone marrow in the middle is really tasty too after you've done cooking that out. So basically, what I would do with these, you want a really nice simple dinner, great for a snowy evening. Season these up, salt and pepper. You get a pan going, nice hot pan going. You can dredge these in a little bit of flour. That just means, basically dredging just means patting them in some flour, okay, so coating them. Put a little bit of oil in that pan at a medium heat, and you fry these on both sides till they're golden. Set those aside. In the meantime, you cook off some onions, some garlic, some carrots, some celery, all chopped up in olive oil, right? You cook, sweat those off, add about a half bottle of red wine, add about a liter or two of chicken stock to it, some bay leaves, some thyme, some peppercorns. You put these back in, make sure they're submerged in the liquid. And then again, when it comes to a simmer, you put a cover on it, put it in an oven at 325, and basically let it go for about 2 hours. 2 hours later, this will be falling off the bone, the meat's delicious. And you can serve that, again, traditionally with a risotto, or you can even just eat it with a little bit of mashed potatoes, which I also like to do a lot. And that is basically your ossobuco.